అడ్వైజరీ కౌన్సిల్ సార్ ప్లీజ్.
రామేశ్వర గారికి అనురుత దేశపాండే గారు ఇతర సోదర సోదరులు అందరికీ కూడా నా హృదయపూర్వక దసరా శుభాకాంక్షలు. సంస్కృతి ఫౌండేషన్ అధ్యయన కేంద్రం శంకుస్థాపన ఈరోజు జరుగుతుంది. దానికి ఈ కార్యక్రమంలో పాల్గొనడానికి అవకాశం ఇచ్చినందుకు నిర్వాహకులందరికీ కూడా ధన్యవాదాలు. శ్రీ వరప్రసాద్ రెడ్డి గారు మరియు మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు, రామచంద్ర రెడ్డి గారు చక్కటి ప్రసంగాలు చేసినారు. అది దానికి తోడు మామేశ్వర గారు కూడా మాట్లాడిన దాన్ని అన్ని కలిపితే దాదాపు మనం నాలాంటి వాడికి ఇంకా ఇచ్చే సలహాలు అంటూ ఏమీ కనబడి అనిపించింది. ఆల్ ది సేమ్, లెట్ మీ పుట్ ఫార్వర్డ్ మై ఓన్ ఫ్యూ థాట్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రాసెస్. I do not intend to touch those aspects which the honorable speakers have touched so far. All of us are aware that our country was endowed with an excellent and respectable culture which was developed over the past several thousands of years. Unfortunately, due to the foreign invasions which continued for centuries together, the culture which was intact for millennia had suffered a serious dent. While the damage to the culture during the alien rule was to certain extent not that much, I am sorry to say that over the past 70 years after our country became independent, a concerted effort was made to denigrate the culture and to develop almost a parallel force in such a way that a typical and an average Indian feels that he has nothing to be proud of and he has only there to learn from other systems. The Sanskriti Foundation is doing an excellent job in this behalf to reinvent the cultural values and to resurrect them to the extent possible. So far we have been successful to a larger extent. This Ajayani Kendra is intended to undertake a typical and specified activity of identifying those values. I can only say this much, that the process of developing a culture, many countries have to undertake a work to bring about a culture or cultural aspect for the first time. Fortunately for us, we do not have to do that, and it would be sufficient if we can reinvent what was there earlier. But only thing is, we have to assimilate those values to the present contemporary society. It is here that the Ajayani Kendra has to undertake certain specified activities. In addition to that, we shall have to identify the forces that worked for all these decades to denigrate our culture and to reduce its value. There are many things. It can be in terms of educational system, cultural values. Varaprasad Reddy Garu has identified various aspects, such as in terms of the temple system, the education system, then so many other aspects. Especially the beauty with the Indian culture is that while in various other cases the benefit of any culture or a system accrues only to the population of that country, in case of India, our ancient culture is such that the entire humanity stands to benefit of it. Let's say we all of us are aware of the ancient saying, సర్వే భవంతు సుఖినః సర్వే సంతు నిరామయ సర్వే భద్రాని పశ్యంతు మా కశ్చిత్ దుఃఖ భాగ్ భవేత్. దట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ అపీల్ ఫర్ ది వెల్బీయింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎంటైర్ హ్యుమానిటీ. నాట్ ఓన్లీ దట్, వీ హ్యాడ్ ప్రేడ్ ఫర్ ది వెల్బీయింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎంటైర్ క్రియేషన్, వెదర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ప్లాంట్స్ ఆర్ ఎనిమల్స్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. ఓవర్ ఇన్ ది వరల్డ్ దేర్ ఇస్ సచ్ ఏ కోఆర్డినేషన్ బిట్వీన్ ది culture, the human beings and the nature. That we have to reinvent. It will take some time, but the beneficiary will be the entire humanity. Our small gesture in this behalf, notwithstanding this the damage we have suffered to our culture, it has been exhibited in the recent past. When the whole world was looking, or every country in the world was just trying to protect their own people, India is the only country which has supplied the equipment and medicines to the entire world without any limitation, including masks. That has been appreciated by one and all. We never think of our limitations when it comes to the question of serving humanity. These values we have gotten everywhere. Our education system is also such that it will subserve the entire humanity. These things need to be reinvented. They are in the Talapatya Grandas or the published editions. The unfortunate part of it is that even where the material is substantially available in the present form, even in the form of written books or even the soft form, but people are not inclined to learn them, and that is where we have to concentrate. Here, of course, the new education policy has made some deviations from the system which has been enforced till recently, on account of the distortion or the various works undertaken by selfish persons, we have reduced the importance of our mother tongue, reduced the importance of our ancient the value system. All that has to be rejuvenated. In addition to that, the organizations like Sanskriti Foundation have a very important task to undertake. The government has its own limitations in the context of implementation of the schemes meant for cultural and ethical rejuvenation. Of course, however rich a person may become, or however rich a country may become, unless the cultural system is kept intact, the richness and the wealth would turn out to be counterproductive. On the other hand, if the cultural system is intact, any accretion in the form of wealth or technology would be of not only help to the entire country, but also to the entire humanity. Here, in the context of the Adhyayana, we have to be a bit conservative with our time frame. In the sense, unlike in government departments, in almost every specialized organization, there is research and development team. Research goes on, but hardly with any development. Not without any, whatever we invent, we identify for the immediate reaction or immediate follow-up action. That must be proven. That must be proven in the form of action, instead of going on conducting research and discussion on it. The more once we take, because the setup of the Sanskriti Foundation is so perfect, hardly any field of activity is left out, and excellent experts are there on every field. So once a particular aspect of the culture or value system is identified as being relevant for the society and its development, then immediate follow-up action, whether in the form of giving concrete suggestions or to putting into action through our own means. There are various organizations which are working in addition to the government departments. How best to put those things in action? Because time cannot stop for us. Therefore, a generation should not be deprived of the excellent wealth of our culture. Therefore, even while concentrating on the reinvention of our values, identifying values, immediate effort should be made to put them into action. These are my few suggestions, and when we meet physically, a more concrete form of suggestions can also come. I thank you all for giving me this opportunity and hearing me patiently.